Let's talk about routing in your Nexus 5 and why you might actually bother. Obviously, Android is an open platform, and the idea behind an open platform is you have full access if you want it, and if in some cases a manufacturer will allow you, Samsung, I'm looking at you, HTC, I'm looking at you, and you can then update the Android operating system. You can tweak all of the little settings that Google have in there to make your device work in different ways. You can also install and run applications which you wouldn't normally be able to do unless you are rooted. And rooting basically means you're elevating your privileges on your device to say, hey, basically I'm Google. You know, I'm a manufacturer and I can do what I like to this device. And it's really what we class as, you know, developer access in many respects. Now, one thing we don't do on this channel is go through the steps of rooting. You will find plenty of videos out on the web and on YouTube about how to root the Nexus 5, and it's a very easy and safe process. If you follow the steps and you've got plenty of battery life on your device, you shouldn't go too far wrong. But why would you root your device? What does it allow you to actually do? Well, at its most basic level, it gives you full control over your purchase. Bearing in mind that a lot of the time when we buy devices, certainly mobile phones, we don't really own our devices as such. We don't have full ownership over every aspect of our smartphones. We're locked out by the manufacturer of certain bits, and those bits might actually be quite useful. You know, they might allow us to save battery life, they might allow us to fix things like the camera by improving the settings the camera uses, they might allow us to run backup utilities to allow us to back up all of our user data, as it were. I know that's probably less of an important aspect now with Android 4.4 and its cloud backup utilities, but for some people, they still prefer to keep their backups where they want to keep them, on their localized computers, up in Google Drive, directly in Dropbox, for instance, or a multitude of different services. So one of the apps that I use an awful lot, obviously testing games and so on and applications across a range of devices, is Helium. Now, what this allows me to do is to take all of the data that is held against a particular application and send it up to a storage unit. So all I need to do is select all here, hit backup, and it'll ask me where I'm going to send it to my Google Drive. I could, if I wanted to store it on the device, I could use Dropbox, box.com or .net or whatever they call themselves, and a variety of other services. And what it does is it goes through my system using its root privileges, basically an elevated type of user that has full access across the system. And it then takes all of that information, packages it up, and sends it up to a cloud storage service, or like I say, onto the device. And then if I want to, I can go to any of my Android devices, which are also rooted and have Helium installed. I can simply open my cloud storage locker, and all of the latest versions of my data is held there waiting for me. I simply tap a few buttons and I can download exactly where that game save was at, the particular settings an app was using, directly to that other handset. And that really is useful from my point of view because it allows me to do much better apple-to-apple comparisons. I really should stop using that term, oranges to oranges comparisons. And the idea there really is that if I've got a set of settings on my Nexus 5, or if I've got a save game on my Nexus 5, I can move it to the Galaxy S4, HTC One, Z1, or any other device, and carry on where I left off, or rerun the tests again using exactly the same settings. It removes some of the error-prone particulars of, you know, trying to replicate settings on both devices. For my mind, it gives you great peace of mind, and more importantly, it works incredibly well, does Helium. This is Helium Pro, or Helium Premium. Well worth it for a couple of quid. It gives you full access to your device via root and allows you to do all of these backups. And I'm just going to cancel that for a second. So if I go into Restore and Sync, you can see here's all my various devices here, and the various backup routines that have been run and the dates. So it also means that I have long-term archives of particular settings. So if I need to, I can jump right the way back, you know, 6 months, 7 months or so, find what settings I was using on a particular app and run those as well, or even from a particular device. And it just works so well. But if I go into Cloud Drive, what it will do is pull in everything that's currently sat within Google Drive, which are backups, and I can then restore any of these I feel like. Hit a button, restore. And it's as simple as that. Done. And so all of the settings from Astro have now been downloaded and installed into Astro. dead easy. Now, another thing that is useful from a point of view of routing is the ability to get much greater control over the low-level settings of your Nexus device. We're all used to coming into here and going, oh look, settings, and you know, here's all our settings. Well, actually that's not even close to all of the settings that are available within an Android device. Most settings are simply not exposed through a GUI. And so what we do is we use something called ROM Toolbox. And this is ROM Toolbox Pro. Now, within ROM Toolbox, it's kind of a collection of tools perfectly designed for rooted users. So realistically, it allows you to reboot your device into fast boot mode or into recovery. It allows you to install ROMs, run particular scripts, boot up your terminal emulator if you need to, and the root browser as well, which allows you to actually browse through all of the areas of the Android operating system that would normally be locked away from you if you were just a normal non-rooted user. And that includes things like the dev folder, your firmware areas, root, obviously it allows you to get into root, but also allows you to get into all of the individual files as well, which make up your Android device. So one of the things we can actually do is to actually come into our performance area here. And we have a series of tweaks that we can perform. Now, one thing I absolutely must say at this point, it is incredibly easy to destroy your device if you screw this up, okay? So only do this if A, you know what you're doing and you've done your research, or B, you don't care if you break your device. For instance, one of the things we can do is we can alter the CPU governor. Now, this actually allows us to clock the processor inside the Nexus 5 much higher than it would normally be, or we can also clock it so it's more conservative than it would normally be, effectively setting the ranges between which the processor will be allowed to run. Now, this can be useful if you want to save battery life or if you want to clock your processor higher, i.e. getting more frames per second out of your games. Bear in mind, if you play around with this and you screw it up, you are probably going to brick your device. Simple as that. You could very well burn your Nexus 5 out, or you could end up clocking it so low it simply takes forever to boot. Bear those things in mind. When you screw up, it is very, very difficult to put them right. Kernel tweaks. This is where we get into the real nitty-gritty. The kernel is what really powers your Android operating system on your device. It handles everything to do with how hardware is going to be interacted with, and it sets the speeds of various things like memory management. Again, if you screw these things up, it can cause a lot of devastation to your device. But these are the things that root allows you to do if you're confident that you have the ability to do these things without breaking them. Build prop editor. This is where we get into the actual settings, underlying settings really, of the Android operating system. One of the things that a lot of people do tend to do is come into here and they look for the LCD density setting here. Now, this particular setting can allow you to alter the density of the text that will, well, text and UI elements that will be displayed on screen. Usually setting your density lower will make the on-screen text and icons smaller, allowing you to fit more information on screen. Bear in mind, altering this value and dropping it too low or too high will generally cause Android to have all sorts of problems, as it stops being able to render various elements onto the screen in the correct way, it gets confused. Your keyboard is usually the thing that crashes. At the moment, I don't have an updated build prop LCD density value for you. It's the sort of thing where you'll have to play around, and if you break it, you'll have to reflash your ROM or try and desperately to install a third-party keyboard like SwiftKey, which doesn't suffer from a density issue if the density is too low or too high. But you've got a huge number of different settings in here. It's the kind of thing where what you need to do is have a read through XDA developer forums, have a look and see what all of these various values do and how they relate to the Nexus 5. But you've got absolutely everything in here. And this is the kind of stuff that routing allows you to do. You also have a task manager as well. Quite useful if you want to see what exactly is hibernating at the moment on your device, or gone to sleep as it were. And an SD booster, which is of no use, I believe, to those of us with the Nexus 5. If you have a separate SD memory card, like in the Galaxy S4, what you can do is you can improve the read-write performance by altering the caching of the SD card in the Galaxy S4, or any device that has a separate SD card. Within interface, we can kind of tweak some of the cooler bits of Android. For instance, we can install custom fonts. You'll have seen a lot of devices where people have like custom home screens and they have like really cool fonts going on. This is how they do it, they use the font installer. And this basically allows you to patch in alternative fonts into Android and it will use those instead. Be warned, not all fonts are usable on a smartphone. A lot of the time, the font that you might think that'll look really cool just looks atrocious and makes the device incredibly difficult to work with. So do be careful of that. What I would do is have a look around, see what fonts other people are using, and obviously how those look on the device. It'll save you a lot of time and trouble. Boot animations. This is, you know, when we turn our Nexus devices on, we get a lovely kind of overlapping set of circles. Well, that's a boot animation. And if we want to, we can change that boot animation for something else. So if you've ever wanted your device when it boots up to have a skull and crossbones on it or run the Matrix code sample, you could have that going on if you wanted to. Theme manager and status bar icons really deal with your icons up at the top of here, and that allows them basically to be changed to really cool, funky stuff if you want. Get rid of the greys and go with something nice and colourful. Bearing in mind, when you do things like this, boot animations, fonts and so on, you may be impacting your battery life slightly as the device has to work a little bit harder on its UI elements. But overall, if you are considering rooting, or if you are rooted already and you're just looking for something to do with it, well, Helium Backup should definitely be one of your first port of calls, and the ROM Toolbox as well. They're both excellent apps, and they provide a great deal of user options for really taking control of your Nexus 5. One of the other apps that I use quite a bit is GUI Manager, and it's just a great way to be able to check on what ROMs are currently available for a rooted device, and then if you want to, you can download them and install them nice and easily. So I hope you've had a good time. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves learning a little bit more about rooting on the Nexus 5 and what kind of things you can do once you're rooted. A lot of it is very geeky, it's very techie stuff, but ultimately, once you have full control of your Nexus or any Android device, you kind of, the limits have been removed. If you want to tweak something, you can. If you want to back something up, you can. Everything is now under your control.